Hello and welcome to Inspira TV. You're watching Newsmakers of the Week, wherein we present to you the top headlines of the week. Me, along with five other staunch reporters, will present to you the top headlines along with the detailed information on the same. Starting with the number of coronavirus cases in India, well, the curve is increasing rapidly as biggest spike is being recorded every day. The greater contributor of the cases in India are the states of New Delhi and Maharashtra, wherein more than 2,000 cases are being recorded every day. The total number of cases now stands at 4 lakh and will cross 4 lakh very soon. And the recovery rate is at 48.5%. The latest update that we have is coming in from Delhi, wherein Satyendra Jain, the health minister of Delhi, has been tested positive and is now in a critical condition.
Well, after talking about the total number of active cases in the country, we now move on to see how well equipped are we on facing the wrath of coronavirus. Prime Minister Narendra Modi held two sets of virtual conferencing with the CMs of all the states as well as union territories on 16th and the 17th of June respectively. On 16th of June, the meeting was held between the chief ministers of 21 states and union territories with the less number of active coronavirus patients in the country. While on 17th, the meeting was held between the remaining 15 states with the highest number of active COVID patients. He also discussed in detail about the situation of country post-unlock 1 and the future plan to deal with the virus outbreak. He stated that presently our country has sufficient amount of PPE kits, ventilators, N95 masks and ICU for all the patients. Also appreciating Punjab's house-to-house surveillance strategy, he asked all other states to apply that model which is helping Punjab to deal with the spread of virus successfully.
After biggest spike being registered every day, the economy of India is a matter of concern. All of us are aware that the pandemic has put the Indian economy in doldrums. COVID-19 pandemic has led to the significant loss to the entire nation's economy. The world's biggest lockdown that shuts the majority of the businesses, factories, suspended flights for so long and restricted the movement of people. So one of the biggest losses for the aviation, hospitality and travel companies because of the competitive prices in the Indian economy. After getting failed to get any actions for the airline sector, the major domestic airlines demands the government to allow the GST credit for economy class operations. Niyant Maru, Chief Financial Minister of Tata SIA Airlines, stated that the government has been always been very supportive and resolved multiple GST issues. But to prevent the ailing of domestic carrier, the government should resolve the issues which is adding on to the cost of operations of the airlines. According to the sources, the airlines industries are ₹75 to 90 crore loss in the pandemic. And according to the International Transport Association, airlines can suffer $1.2 and passengers falling 50%.
The pandemic has brought in the new normals. Let's have a look at the change in the field of cricket. The ICC decision to ban the use of saliva on cricket balls, at least for the time being, has split the cricket world. While many of the people think it's a good move, but people feel that it will further tilt the balance towards the bat. Paras Anand, owner of SG, said that the idea is to maintain balance between bat and the ball. And if the bowlers are not able to use saliva, the sign that they used to try and used to get for the reverse swing will not be that easy. Reference to this, Australia cricket ball manufacturer Kokapura is developing a wax applicator that allows the player to shine the ball without using saliva or sweat.
After talking about the development on the pandemic, the next top story of the week is the India-China face-off at Ladakh. 20 Indian soldiers, including a colonel, were martyred in a violent face-off on Monday night with the Chinese troops in Galwan Valley at Ladakh, said the government sources, in a massive escalation after a week of tension at the border. India retaliated and there were casualties on both the sides, said the army. India said that the clash happened as a result of attempt by the Chinese side to unilaterally change the status quo there, rebutting China claims that Indian soldiers crossed the border. This is the fatal clash since 1975 between India and China, who fought a border war in 1962. The country's top political establishment and the army chief met late night on Tuesday, shortly after the army claimed that 20 Indian soldiers have been martyred in the violent face-off. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on 17th of June that he want to assure the nation that the sacrifice of our Indian soldiers will not go in vain. He further warned China in a strong message stating that no one should be in any doubt. India wants peace, but if when provoked, it is capable of giving a fitting reply, be it any situation. Prime Minister Narendra Modi further called off presidents of political parties for all-party meeting on Friday at 5 p.m. in order to discuss about the situation at the India-China border after Ladakh clash.
Let us all shift the focus to the top story of this week, the untimely dismiss of the very talented and a humble actor Sushant Singh Rajput. According to his representatives and the Mumbai police, the Kaipoche actor hanged himself to death. Well, the whole nation is mourning over the death of Sushant Singh Rajput. This devastating event has left his family, his friends, his fans in a deep shock. Well, his colleague from Bollywood chose social media to represent their grief on this event. The death of the actor did not only bring grief but also rose the debate over nepotism which has been prevailing in our industry. Many directors, many actors started speaking about nepotism. Well, the actor Kangana Ranaut has been praised by the public for giving a very bold comment on nepotism. Filmmaker Karan Johar, Alia Bhatt were subjected to criticism for making nasty comment on Sushant Singh Rajput on different episodes of Coffee with Karan. But hashtags like boycott Bollywood, boycott star kids were mostly used in Twitter by the late actor fans. Thank you. With this, we would also want you to know that Inspiria TV is coming up with its first ever e-media fest, which will be held on a national level. The lineup of 10 events, more than 1,000 participants, eminent speakers coming in. Go visit our website, link in the description box, and get yourself registered. Till then, stay safe. Take care.